And I want to break down an actual question for you. So if you're interested in watching that, please stay tuned. Hello, welcome back to my channel, Mental Health with Melissa. I'm Melissa, I'm a licensed clinical social worker. If you're new here, please don't forget to hit the like and subscribe button for more content. I post videos every single Wednesday and Sunday. Subscribing to my channel really helps me get information out there to those that are interested in the mental health professions that are hoping to become LCSWs, and also mental health information to our communities of color, because there's still that stigma and we want to help break down that stigma. So today, if you clicked on this video, you are interested in learning more about the LCSW exam, particularly about diagnoses. So hopefully you've been studying some of the DSM categories for your test, and I want to break down an actual question for you. So if you're interested in watching that, please stay tuned. So I wanted to go over the diagnosis of generalized anxiety disorder. Also, the acronym is GAD. Now, there may be some specific questions on the test that will test your ability to kind of rule out other diagnoses and diagnose for GAD. GAD is a very well-known diagnosis in the DSM-5 and among clinicians, both medical and mental health. And so we want to break that down. So let's take a look at a practice test question. Okay, so we're gonna take a look at this vignette here to get a better understanding of some of these major diagnoses in the DSM. A 32-year-old woman is referred by her medical doctor for therapy. She anxiously shares that she has been having trouble staying asleep, has racing thoughts, and difficulty concentrating. She states these symptoms started 8 months ago because before that she does not remember trouble with the above. What diagnosis should the therapist consider? Okay, let's break down the options here. A, adjustment disorder. Now, if we know that adjustment disorder, if we've been studying this, usually lasts only up until 6 months, then we know that this is probably not a possibility. Plus, we don't know about any major change, shift, or loss in her life. And usually with adjustment disorder, we can assume that there's something going on with the loss of a job or a major adjustment, just as it's stated in the actual diagnosis, but we just have these symptoms to base things off of. So it has been more than 6 months, so we're going to cross off adjustment disorder. Depressive disorder. Now, do any of the things on here communicate symptoms of depressive disorder? So trouble staying asleep, so that's one. Racing thoughts isn't necessarily a criteria of depressive disorder. So let's keep reading. Generalized anxiety disorder. Okay, so if we know that generalized anxiety disorder requires that somebody have symptoms such as issues with sleep, racing thoughts, difficulty concentrating for 6 months or more, and she has had these symptoms for 8 months now, then we can consider this generalized anxiety disorder. Unspecified anxiety disorder would be if her symptoms were less than 6 months. Another question that comes up is diagnoses that test your ability to rule out specific depressive diagnoses. So let's take a look at a practice test example. So now we're going to be moving on to this vignette. A 28-year-old man presents to you for therapy after losing his job, endorsing symptoms of sleeping 15 hours a day, lack of appetite, and extreme sadness. He states he just lost his job 8 days ago and started having these reported symptoms about 10 days ago. What is the most appropriate diagnosis considering all factors? So let's go through the options. Major depressive disorder. Okay, so if we're taking a look at the criteria for major depressive disorder, again, if we've been studying what each of these diagnoses criteria entail, then we know that
there has to be at least, again, that main word, at least 2 weeks of symptoms. Now, it's only been 10 days. So let's move on. B, unspecified depressive disorder. So unspecified depressive disorder clearly states that it's a lighter impact than major depressive disorder and doesn't meet the full criteria for major depressive disorder. So it hasn't been exactly 2 weeks yet, so we can consider it. Let's move on to see if anything else kind of connects here. Unspecified anxiety disorder. Now, do any of these symptoms sound like anxiety? So lack of appetite, that seems like it could be certainly a symptom of anxiety, but we don't see anything else in here that kind of points to anxiety. So no, bipolar disorder is kind of just way out there. We don't see anything about mania. We do see symptoms of depression, but doesn't seem to fit the mold. So we're going to go back and look at unspecified depressive disorder. It looks like unspecified depressive disorder is the correct answer because he experiences symptoms of major depressive disorder, but again, it has been less than 2 weeks. So B is going to be your answer.
So I hope that was helpful. Let me know in the comments section below if there are other specific diagnosis questions that you have, or if there are other specific questions on the LCSW exam that you would like to break down. I'm happy to do it. Until next time, managing mental health matters.